Excellent job. Sandy, do you have any questions?
First of all, I think what you're doing is admirable. I think so often people who suffer with mental issues are often forgotten, so I applaud you for making this so personal. My question is, for people at home, what would it cost for a family to have it in their home? And is this something that you envision insurance covering as a way to supplement?
It's a great question. So, of course, we envision insurance covering for that. There is no reason why people should cover for that. Today, it costs $50 per month. And, of course, we have an annual plan and a six-month plan. But exactly this is our goal, to reach a situation where insurance companies will cover that. So we have these few years where people are still will still need to pay for that, and this is part of the help we need, is in these next years to get support. To play the game, you need to have hardware, a console, that provides you different biofeedback. And today we provide this because many of these people don't have a lot of money that they can spend on software and hardware. So we provide it either on discount and many times for free. And this is something that a startup company like us, it's very difficult for us to do. So it's definitely that. And we already see insurance companies, for example, in Israel, we are now having a pilot with a big HMO. It's an insurance provider that wants to use our product for telerehabilitation. We have discussions with some big network in the US. But it takes them like between one time we talk to them to another, takes them like 6 months or a year. So, you know, it will take time to get to that.
Anyone else? So, one of the biggest differentiators from what I've seen in ventures that make it and those that don't is the relentless focus. The focus that needs to be demonstrated and not getting distracted to be all things to all people. And you have an enterprise solution and you have a consumer solution. So I'm curious, when you think about scaling the business, where do you see the driving of revenues coming from? And then separate from that, what is the area that you personally want to be working on as the entrepreneur in the business?
So it's a great question. Indeed, we're very focused on the acquired manager market today, and our next market is aging. So in terms of the medical condition, we're focused. In terms of the home versus institution, we started by going towards the biggest and the most appealing institutions for several reasons. One, to get their inputs and to work together with them. For example, Shepherd Center, which is one of the top 10 in the US, we collaborated very closely with them to develop the product. We also want them as the recommenders, and they are already. They're recommending their patients when they leave the rehabilitation hospital to use our software. So in this field, it sort of has to be, it doesn't have to be, you also can develop only for the home, but if you want to be practical, people turn to their therapist to get a recommendation. So, and we're lucky that therapists really understand our value proposition. So we're going, it's a bit hard, I totally understand what you're saying, but our focus is totally the home. The institutions are the vehicle. So if I have two features, the home is the first. And the home is in my heart, and by the way, also in the business model. This is the scalable business model.
Yeah, that's what I have.
Yeah, so we're aligned on the social and the commercial.
Yeah,
but
that you're okay. Before anyone else has questions,
I would just like to piggyback on that question. Doesn't this treatment need to be tailor-made per person, depending on the level of brain damage and so on? And what kind of support can you bring, and how scalable is this?
What kind of support?
Support do you bring, if that person needs help and advice?
Yeah.
Cannot go all the way to an institution, a hospital?
So, just before I answer the question, I must remind that the problem that we're trying to address, the main problem, is really helping people that don't have therapists, don't have the rehabilitation hospital. There are tons of them, as you mentioned, and like many of us know. This is the reason why we developed this software that is adaptable. We have very complex algorithms. You saw Dr. Balogun said, which is part of our algorithms team, that basically personalize the software in real time to the performance of the person, both in terms of physical ability and cognitive ability. So if you're managing to succeed in the task we give you, we advance it more. If you don't manage, we reduce it by various parameters. And this is the key, one of the key advantages to our software, and that allows it to also be used to various levels of
abilities. We start by, like, the patients we started with are severe TBI. We gradually went up to moderate, like to develop all the algorithms for that, and gradually went up more. It doesn't fit healthy people today, although in the vision, all of us will be going not only to the gym, but using the intended training at home. But we sort of first care about the people who really need it the most, and later we care about us, which we can manage without it.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Sonia.
Thank you.
I am bringing you with me everywhere. I love you. And I apologize to Sun. Nobody told me you were a daughter before you came out, and I called you a he, and I apologize. Next up is Neil from Thailand with Siam Organics.